Are you ready to flip the script on your debt?
Yes, I am.
Moving forward with the Dekker team. Moving forward together with the Dekker team.
We are honored that we've been able to create for you free access to over 653 Life's Inside Track episodes. And the great news is you can get access to them from pretty much anywhere in any form you want, podcast, video. And if you haven't subscribed to the YouTube channel, like, get at it so that you get them as soon as they come out. We're going to explore that our mindset, the way we think about debt, could it be holding us hostage?
It could be, especially if we fear debt.
All types of debt, right? Which is the gig. So what we want to talk about is how the right debt, the debt that pays you rather than the debt you pay, could in fact be your ally.
All right. Now, what's some of the distinguishing factors of a, and I know you don't like the good, bad debt.
I don't love good, bad.
But you do like the fact that there is debt that will pay you and there's debt that you pay for.
Yes, I do get that.
So, what's the differentiation of the debt that pays you?
Well, the debt that pays you is usually debt that you've acquired that's at a low, low interest rate or a lower interest rate. And then what it pays you is at a much higher rate than what you're paying.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yeah,
absolutely.
Can
you say it a different way so that it is easy to land for everybody? Because we've been so conditioned to go, debt's bad, debt's bad, debt's bad. Got to pay off my house, got to pay off my house, got to pay off my house. And
so it's debt that can create income and wealth for you, and preferably both at the same time, income and wealth, while you're paying it on a low interest rate, like a line of credit or a mortgage on a property. Because that's significantly lower than consumer debt on a credit card. Or even if you buy at a don't pay a cent event and you have total intention to pay it off as before it's due and you miss that due date and then suddenly it's at a high interest, and some of them are high interest from the original time you bought it, not just from that day forward. So watch out for those contracts. Read every single word of those. And that's the differentiator between high interest debt. And even sometimes people say, well, I want to get into this property, but I can't afford to get regular lending. We have to be careful because if we start spending 16, 18% interest rate for second mortgages and stuff to get into something.
Or B lenders or C lenders.
We may be trying too hard.
Right.
And it may be costing all the benefit of owning it. So we look at that case by case. Does it make sense because something's shifting, another property's selling in, you know, 2 months, or we're changing it so that its value is increasing significantly and then we can refinance it. So sometimes a higher debt for a short period of time may be wise. But we've got to judge that and be very, very, very careful on that.
Right. And when you were using the example of a no pay cent event, even if you get it paid off in time, if that purchase is not a need, you may be further ahead to use that money toward an investment versus something that doesn't pay you.
Yeah.
Right? So it's this whole conversation of, are you getting paid or are you paying for it?
It's the delayed gratification sometimes. If we put our money into savings and investments first, the investments can start buying the things that we want as opposed to us working for the money to buy the things that we want.
Right. And September 25th, what's happening?
Oh, we're having this little get-together at our office at 5 Corvus Court. Don't show up unless you bought a ticket because it's going to be a packed house, I think. And you can still get a ticket if you go online to deckerteam.com. There'll be a pop-up. Follow the prompt, click on the thing. You can buy a ticket. It's $47 for the family, 15 and up. 15 years of age and up. But your teenagers need to have you with them in the room. Maybe they'll buy the ticket for you, but you got to come with them.
Yeah, both. Yes, absolutely. Because part of what we know is when we talk about this debt paying you versus you paying for debt, if we, that's almost non in alignment with culture, right?
Yeah, because culture or what you said, like familia, the way that your family brought you up around finances or the way they used money.
Right.
Is typically how you're going to use it unless you go out and get new knowledge.
Right. And when you get the new knowledge, if you just get it by yourself, you're the freak in the storm. Rather than if
you get the freak in the storm,
rather than doing it in community, doing it inside family. Like, don't just get a ticket or let your kids buy you a ticket, your teenagers. Get other teenagers to buy their parents tickets and all go as a community or at the event.
Do you know, I just realized
the workshop get a new community gathered together, because if you're freaks together, a freak in the storm together, you'll actually probably follow through.
Yeah.
Otherwise it's hard.
We were freaks in the storm. We found our way through the storm.
Yes.
By ourselves, by reading. But we didn't have family or people come alongside us in that way, other than at the church. We did get into a financial small group workshop thing, which started. But it was reading. We needed to blaze a new trail that our families hadn't. You know, your parents ended up good, but our families hadn't blazed that trail,
and
we needed to,
and your mom never did.
No.
And so, and unfortunately, they both passed. And so, while they still hadn't figured this thing out. Mm-hmm. So, we knew, even though we were messing up big time and following a pattern, that debt somehow had to start paying us rather than us paying just
It's really
debt.
Weird that debt is the answer.
I know. Just in a twisted...
It's like, a twisted thing, yeah.
Twisted.
Okay. So, what... Would you use debt for, Yetta? Like education, buying a business?
Especially in education that I have a high ability to get a job in. Like, we have one of our dear clients and friends where the young woman is working. She's got some money from grandparents. She's attempting not to accumulate too much debt. And that debt is going to serve her moving forward because she knows it's a career that she will be able to get a position in. She knows there's high demand, and especially high demand for women in this particular industry. So calculating how it might serve you.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, when I think about investment properties, because that's one of the ways, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
We overpaid significantly, I would say, at the time for our first four investment properties because they were all bailout of a current client. We didn't understand investing. This is like 33 years ago or thereabouts. And we did it to help someone else to get out of a bind. Mm-hmm. And the only way we could help them, or the best way we could help them, was pay more than the market would bear because they weren't selling in the marketplace.
Mm-hmm.
And yet, that overpaid real estate set us up to still build equity and be able to buy our business.
Mm-hmm.
And now our business pays for the real estate that we're in.
That's true.
How crazy.
It's
how awesome.
It's awesome. So we are honored that we get to be here and provide options, because when your options are clear, your wisdom will flow.
Moving forward with the Dekker team. Moving forward.